Hello everybody, my name is Patrick Bitature. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about mentorship. It's a very interesting subject, and I see it's a growing industry in Uganda. And people don't seem to tell the difference between mentorship and coaching. They're very similar in some areas, but there's a big difference. And I think there's a huge gap. The industry has really got to grow. And the true mentors, that is people with experience, whether in the corporate world, in the companies, in business, or in education, have got to step up. So many people have got lovely ideas, have got a lot of experience and a lot of wisdom, and are simply not sharing it. I think this is very unfortunate. We've got to change this trajectory where people who know should share, and those who are keen to learn should listen and grab this wisdom so that they don't make the mistakes or don't fall in the pitfalls that those who have traveled this journey before have had to go through. That is why we all study a bit of history. Now, I'd like to use the analogy of a football team. In the UK, the English Premier League, you have teams that are so famous globally, like Manchester United, Liverpool, Arsenal, Manchester City, blah, blah, blah. The name goes on. And so do they, and a similar thing is happening in Europe and in Spain, where you have La Liga, and you have teams like Juventus, you have the very famous one, Real Madrid. I don't keep a tab of all these teams, and I know about some of these players, the very famous players, Ronaldo, who. So we hear about them, and they play a fantastic game out there. The whole world is gripped when they're playing, especially when they come to their finals. Is this game any different from the game we play in Uganda? One football, 11 people on this side, 11 people on this side, a linesman on either side, and one referee. The rules are the same. But who knows how many of the players we have in the Uganda Cranes, or in Villa, or in Express, or in the other teams, URA. We don't pay attention to them. Why is the level of play so different? When a team in Europe doesn't do well, who is the first person that is sacked? The coach. Not the striker. Not the goalkeeper who let the goal in because he missed the ball or wasn't paying attention. The coach. A coach is a very important person. And when you get things wrong, your team isn't producing or performing, you're the first one to go. Why isn't it the same in the business world, in the real world? The coach, the person who trains you and sees that you're delivering and performing. Now, a mentor goes beyond just coaching. A mentor has got experience. And that's why half the time the coaches are former football professionals. So a mentor must bring his experience, draw upon his experience, on his wisdom, and share it, impart it, to make sure that the team is delivering. Look at another sport, in golf. When Tiger Woods was doing so well, somebody was mentoring him. In boxing, one of the greatest boxers of all time, Muhammad Ali, he was great. He had a fantastic coach, someone who will train you. When he becomes floppy and starts taking things for granted because he's made so much money, he starts going down. Tyson came, Wonder Boy, and then went down. So you must always pay attention to that part of mentorship and coaching. In a country, when you have a good leader, the country keeps growing. There's no difference in any organization. You need good leadership and you need mentorship. Someone who sees beyond you, has a vision of where we're going, and sees the milestones that are necessary to achieve before you jump some of them, and keeps pushing you so that you can do better, perform better. That's why we need many more people in this field of mentorship. I see many seasoned bankers, they retire and just go to farming. They've got nothing to do with, it's got nothing to do with their experience, and they go into learning a completely new field. Yet they could use that experience to help young people access finance, know what it takes. People, there are so many accountants being churned out. Help people to manage their businesses much better. Lawyers, instead of just waiting for an opportunity to fight with one another and take advantage of people, help people understand what commercial contracts mean, the language of money, the language of law, how to communicate better, how to communicate effectively. These are all tools at our disposition, but are grossly underutilized. Muhammad Ali was not just a great puncher, because you must be, to get in that ring, you must be able to give a strong punch that counts, but you must be also able to take a good punch. Guys came who were much heavier, stronger than him, and could give a heck of a punch. George Foreman was one. When he came, he was the butcher. Muhammad Ali knew he could not withstand this man. And so we had this famous thing. Joe Frazier was another, rope the dope, where you've got to be able to stay in a corner, let him tire out, and then you give your sharp punches.
And that's how he became the greatest of all time. So it's not about giving the punch. You've got to balance it with also being able to take the punch. And that's what happens in the real world. You may have your great ideas, you know how to execute them, but will you compete with the other players? How do you fare in the environment in which you're working? You may excel in Europe. Will you excel in Africa? Will you excel in Uganda? Our environment is slightly different. You've got to acclimatize. You've got to learn your environment. You've got to see where the opportunities are and how to convert them. How do you commercialize them? How do you do good in a society and do well personally or as a company? This is the right balance, and that's what success means. Otherwise, you will live a life that is empty. You've been collecting things, collecting property, collecting money. At the end of the day, what was the journey for? It helps to live a life of purpose and meaning. If you can do well, if you can do good for society and do well in the process, you feel fulfilled. You have done well. And many people do it in different ways. Some come out very strong and want to make their statement, it's all about them. Some have built banks and empires, and we can see where they're going. Some have been very humble. The late Mzee Mukwano was one of them. Quietly doing things, creating value in a country, creating goods, building industries, and creating jobs, and living a very humble life. There are different approaches, but you need a mentor to see where you fit in best and to get it right. It helps that you look up to somebody who's smarter than you. Don't go to somebody who has no money to advise you on how to invest your money. That's why you go to somebody who's got a lot of money. If he's got the time, all you're asking for is advice. How can you make some money? If you've got 10 million shillings, how can you invest it? But if you've got somebody also who's got less than 10 million shillings and he's the one advising you how to invest your money, don't you have some question marks around the whole situation? So I think you've got to think about getting a mentor. Don't make it a full-time job, and don't nag somebody that my mentorship means you've got, I'm so demanding on you. Make it a two-way thing so that the communication is effective. Show your gratitude, show your appreciation. I get so many young people, some are polite and they get into a mentorship program. Some come insisting and feel entitled to get into it. And I say, what have you done? Why is it worth my time to mentor you? So you've got to earn that position, because there are so many young people looking for mentorship, and I can only train so many at a time. But those who come around me, it hurts me if you don't succeed. I want everybody who comes near me, walks in my life, even if you're an employee. If you leave me, you should be successful. You should learn much more than just having got the benefit of having a job and an income. You learn how to do things differently. You learn to process differently. You are practical. You are pragmatic. You are compassionate. You can be kind. You can care for your staff. Show that feeling that you are kind and you genuinely care about them. You must be authentic. If you live a life like that, you touch so many lives. And in the process, you start mentoring many more people. And it's useful. I'm not doing it so that I'll be remembered as a great person. I do it because I want to have a fulfilling life. I do it because I feel it is selfish of me to think I will only impart to my immediate family what I know. I think what I have learned, what I've acquired is from this country. I must give back. That fulfills my purpose. Also, it has a spiritual angle of giving. And the feeling of giving is so much more rewarding than that of getting. But when you've got nothing, getting is the best thing. Until you reach a certain level, then you appreciate that actually giving is even more satisfying. So we will get there. Let's begin with the basics. Let's get people into mentorship programs. Those with a bit of wisdom, experience, share it. You've got nothing to lose. There is so much information out there, especially on the internet today. So it's available, it's free. What you are seeing, if you're seeing this on YouTube, I'm not paying for it. You're not paying for it, most likely. Maybe it's because you buy bandwidth, but the information is out there. And there are many more people out there much smarter than me giving out information freely and willingly. Use it to make your life a bit better. Thank you.